Gospel musician Tasha Cobbs, remember the lady for that song, Breaking These Chains, recently had an interview where she was talking about what happened by the time when she asked for prayers for Beyonce, you know? Yeah, you remember that time?
Mm-hmm.
And so she was talking about, you know, how she, you know, where her mind was around that time. Now, on this video, I want to highlight verses that kind of elaborate where is the mind of a person and what is it that a mind of a person who's being carnal, what they don't see, you know? And I think Tasha, with her hat over there, Utengili hair too, girl. Which one is this one? Which what kind of a hat is that one? But anyways, apart from fashion, you know, I don't have fashion sense. I mean, like, I'm just a blue outfit guy. So we need to, I want us to see what a carnal person does not see when you are addressing spirituality and carnality. And I think Tasha exhibits that perfectly. It's the reality show. We do daily Christian commentary videos. If it's the first time over here, you be sure to check out some other videos that are down in the pinned comments, and I'm gonna check you out when you get over them. So I'm gonna play you the video, and then I'm gonna read you maybe one or two verses that illustrate carnal mind. And a person is carnal, it's completely carnal. Now, what was Tasha saying? She was asked, you know, mindset, where were you? Blah, blah, blah. You know, the whole nine quadrants. And this is what Tasha said.
Because a lot of people look at the finished product or what they think is finished.
Right.
And they're like, I want to, they aspire to be.
I want that.
But they don't know, the price tag hasn't been flipped over.
Yeah. This we keep it real, right?
Very real.
The question that you're asking me, I'm about to jump right on out here right now.
Yeah.
A few months ago, I woke up, literally, it was early morning, so that had to be God, because I'm not a morning person, okay? Anytime I wake up early, he is talking, okay? I woke up early, and I started to, it's gonna be challenging. I started to say to my husband, this was before the tour and everything, I said to him, man, I wonder what it costs Beyonce to do what she does. Like, you can't go anywhere. There's nowhere she can go where people aren't watching, taking pictures. How is she moving? Nobody's asking how you feel today.
Right.
That doesn't matter.
Right, absolutely.
You get up there, you perform.
Yep.
And you come down. I wonder. I just started asking questions. I wonder if she's depressed. I wonder, you know, if she has people she can talk to. So I got online and I said, hey, I just want to pray for Beyonce. Calling all of the intercessors, let's pray for Beyonce. And my heart towards that was exactly what your heart is towards me. What does it cost you to get up every day? I'm not asking about, you know, if you got on the side of the bed and said, God, could you save me today?
Right, exactly.
I just really want to know if you're okay.
Yeah, for sure.
And I was attacked tremendously for praying. But guess what? I'm not going to stop.
Amen. Absolutely correct.
No problem, Tash. No problem. Now, I'm going to highlight this. And I think it's quite an interesting one, because she says, you know, she's not going to stop. She was attacked for praying. How dare we attack Tasha for praying? After all, we all know Tasha is all about that prayer. Now, maybe the girls forgot. You know, Tasha, we've come to know her to be a person who's really into fame. Like, she really wants to blow up. She wants to become mainstream. And how far do you see? How do you see it? Because you'll remember Tasha is the same lady that has a song with Nicki Minaj talking about blessed. The name of the song. So, having seen you at that level of willing to be all the way carnal with our Nicki Minaj in seeking to be mainstream, We know you're extremely a carnal person. She's not just a carnal person. She's an extreme version of a person who's extremely carnal, disguising it spirituality. No, you know, she was just thinking about prayer, you know. Does Beyonce have anyone to talk to? You want to talk to Beyonce? What? You want collaboration also over there? Because we know you's a carnal one. You were there busy singing with Nicki Minaj. I don't think you was over there praying. Tasha, we know you. You carnal. Girl. This girl out here playing funny with us. But this is the mind of a carnal person. They try to convince you that they have a spiritual goal, you know. At the back of their mind, there's some form of idea that leads to something spiritual. I see, Lee, Martin. We are not stupid. We know your kind. You want collaboration. I was. You want the beehive type of thing. Carnal. And it's not just the head. You are carnal. It's not just the head. I live in here. I don't know where that head is facing, but it's not doing it for me. We know where your heart is. You've shown us where your heart is. So, in the name of, you were attacked because you were praying. No, we know why you stated that prayer. Around that time, Beyonce was being rebuked by people over her tour. She thinks we forgot. Beyonce was being rebuked for her tour where she was busy climbing a horse. And we know where she gets the reference of the horse. It's the horseman of the apocalypse in Revelation. She mimics herself like that. She always rides the horse and whatnot. Beyonce liked those imagery. And at the same time, people were recalling the time when she used the Nigerian god of destruction in her African tour, the whole thing, African tour thing that she did, where she was collaborating with African artists, where she was endorsing Yoruba gods, Nigerian gods. So we know where Beyonce is. We have no conversations with Beyonce until she sorts herself. Beyonce is a claimed Christian who, when she does something occultic, you know, she decided this one. She knows what she's doing. When Beyonce went out wearing that ring with devil horns, where was Tasha Cobbs with their prayers? Bo to lead. You're nonsense when Natasha. You're full of nonsense. You're very carnal. Very, very carnal. Now, anyways, let's get to the verses. This is I was attacked for, you know, feelings. Hey, Christians with feelings. That's exactly what I was talking about when we talked about the other story of the lady who went to the other show, to Gogo's Kotani show. I stated this thing, not particularly about her, but how Christians were reacting to it. I've been very emotional. No, you know, Abazalani, Abanai, shut up. This is a shut up. All these feeling people, they prefer feelings over doctrine. Someone says something that's biblically wrong. When you are busy, maybe, you know, what you are saying to them is not going to make them feel right. What did they think we felt when they were talking nonsense? Teaching people nonsense. So, before you tell us feelings, she was there. She was concerned how Beyonce was feeling. Utkwela my feelings when I get away. Utkwela feelings. Now, the verse that I really want us to highlight here, it's Romans chapter number 1, verse 23. Now, in Romans chapter 1, he's highlighting people that are disrespectful. They know God, but they don't retain him in how they portray themselves. And so, in chapter number 1, verse 23, this is what the Bible says about that. Verse 23, if I highlight it over here, and that's what 23 says. These people that is talking about, who profess themselves to be wise, but they become fools in how they portray themselves. He says, they changed the glory of the incorruptible God into an image made in the likeness of corruptible man. So when she sings holy, holy, she mingles it with gospel. She's portraying, because remember, gospel music is a portrayal of God's message, right? And so when a person is over there, like Tasha Cobbs, singing gospel music, and then mixing it with foul hip-hopping, oh, Nicki Minaj's and whatnot, she is changing the image of the incorruptible image of the gospel to corruptible man and birds into birds. And notice that part there, and birds and forfeitable beasts and creeping things. So notice, remember, the idea of birds, when birds are mentioned within scripture, it's a highlight of demonic beings that take doctrine or the value of truth. If you remember the seed, when the seeds are thrown on the wayside, the birds, they come and pick the seed and they fly away with it, which we know to be demonic figures that take away the value of truth and replace it for others. So, Abu Tasha Cobbs, let's come back here. What do? They want to mingle the foul to a point where people have no reference of what truth is like. Corrupt people, okay? But then if you go all the way to roughly about Romans chapter number 12, if you go to chapter 12, there's something that it tells us in Romans chapter number 12, right? And that is, let me just light off this here and let's get it in focus here. Now, it says, Romans chapter 12, I beseech you, brethren, by the mercies of God, that he present your bodies, okay? That includes everything that mandems be busy with out there. I beseech you, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies as living sacrifices, acceptable unto God. It's not what you would receive. It's what is acceptable to God. Acceptable unto God. And he says, which is the only reasonable sacrifice. Be ye not conformed to the world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. It is the word of God. When you do not mix it with foul and unbiblical things, change over to this one. Okay? So that makes it easier for us to understand that what she's presenting, when she keeps she just wanted to pray for Beyonce, but we were so heartless that we rebuked her for it. So what does that tell you? It tells you Tasha Cobbs' compromise goes so far that it ignores mingling corrupt things with God's image, the gospel. Bazalwan, a person who's carnal, that's what they do. The Tasha Cobbs of the world who are corrupt in the way that they, you guys were just attacking me. No, we know you, Tasha. You are a carnal person. You are carnal. There is nothing to it, girls. Oh, girls, they must come down. There is nothing to it. When you just want to mix, like the Nicki Minaj collaboration, yeah, you just want to mix the world with things. You want to present the holy and the unholy, bringing corruption. So we know your kind. And I thought this was a perfect example. She doesn't get it. And you can see in the interview that was recently done. When was this? Was this 3 weeks ago? According to the interview, I think, I hope you saw that it's actually 2 weeks ago. So if you actually focus it on that one, you'll actually see that this was actually 2 weeks ago. And so that shows you Tasha Cobbs still thinks she's in the right. Tasha Cobbs still thinks she is in the right, particularly with how she handled that. Bazalwane, a person who is carnal, there is a way that you see they retain themselves into the ideas of what they hold. And unfortunately for people like Tasha, they remain convinced in nonsense. You know, I was attacked for praying. And I'll continue. No, you continue being carnal. We know you're kind. And to corrupt everyone. It's the reality show, the daily Christian commentary videos. If it's the first time over here to be sure, check out some other videos that are down in the big comments, and I'm gonna check you out over there. Beware of such people. They don't retain. Notice Romans chapter 1. They don't retain God as we know him. They present God with the corruptible. They don't keep it pure. They don't keep it as they see it. They have to taint it, foul it up, wrap it with things. Creates a problem. It's Ricky, and I'm going to check you out on the next episode. Down in the pink comments, y'all have a good one.